Mr. Chief Justice, members of the Senate, 2 weeks ago we started this trial promising to show you that the President withheld $391 million of foreign military aid to coerce an ally at war to help him win the 2020 election. And by many of your own admissions, we succeeded in showing you that, because the facts still matter. We also promised you that eventually all of the facts would come out, and that continues to be true. But we didn't just show you that the President abused his power and obstructed Congress. We painted a broader picture of President Trump, a picture of a man who thinks that the Constitution doesn't serve as a check on his power, but rather gives it to him in an unlimited way, a man who believes that his personal ambitions are synonymous with the good of the country, a man who, in his own words, thinks that if you're a star, they will let you do anything. In short, it's the picture of a man who will always put his own personal interests above the interests of the country that he has sworn to protect. But what's in an oath, anyway? Are they relics of the past? Do we simply recite them out of custom? To me, an oath represents a firm commitment to a life of service, a commitment to set aside your personal interest, your comfort, and your ambition to serve the greater good, a commitment to sacrifice. I explained to you last week that I believe America is great not because of the ambition of any one man, not simply because we say it's true, but because over our almost 250-year history, millions of Americans have taken the oath and they meant it. Many of them followed through on that oath by giving everything to keep it. But there is more to it than simply keeping your word, because an oath is also a bond between people who have made a common promise. Perhaps the strongest example is the promise between the Commander-in-Chief and our men and women in uniform. Those men and women took the oath with the understanding that the Commander-in-Chief, our President, would always put the interests of the country in their interests above his own, and understanding that his orders will be in the best interests of the country, and that their sacrifice in fulfilling those orders will always serve the common good. But what we have clearly shown the last few weeks, and what President Trump has shown us the past few years, is that this promise flows only one way. As Maya Angelou said, "When someone shows you who they are, believe them the first time." Many of us in this room are parents. We all try to teach our kids the important lessons of life. One of those lessons is that you won't always be the strongest, you won't always be the fastest, and you won't always win. There are a lot of things outside our control, but my wife and I have tried to teach our kids that what we can always control are our choices. It's in that spirit that hanging in my son's room is a quote from Harry Potter. The quote is from Professor Dumbledore, who said, "It is our choices that show who we truly are, far more than our abilities." This trial will soon be over, but there will be many choices for all of us in the days ahead, the most pressing of which is how each of us will decide to fulfill our oath. More than our words, our choices will show the world who we really are, what type of leaders we will be, and what type of nation we will be. So let me finish where I began, with an explanation of why I am here, standing before you. I've been carrying my kids' constitutions these last few weeks, and this morning I wrote a note to them to explain why I'm here. Our founders recognized the failings of all people, so they designed a system to ensure that the ideas and principles contained in this document would always be greater than any one person. It's the idea that no one is above the law. But our system only works if people stand up and fight for it. And fighting for something important always comes with a cost. Someday, you may be called upon to defend the principles and ideas embodied in our Constitution. May the memory and spirit of those who sacrificed for them in the past guide you and give you strength as you fight for them in the future. Thank you for your time.